I cannot teach you or anybody anything. I can only help you think.
Oh, shit.
Take the time to look at yourself, understand who you are and what you want.
Socrates, when you look at it all, and I mean truly look at it, how do you keep yourself from suicide? I mean, how I see it, life is full of pain and misery and only the ignorant could ever live happily.
Son, if you truly believe life is only pain...
No, but really, my feet hurt and the sun burns my back and the flowers die. The cold leaves us ill and the night leaves us blind. Love's more painful than it is joyful and it almost always fades. Sure, you can talk to us in metaphors, but when it really comes down to surviving each day, none of this helps.
Yeah, wait, what the fuck?
Plato! Look, my students, you're walking down a dark path. You mustn't doubt me. I am wise, for I can admit that I know nothing.
What?
It's like if he doesn't have the answers, how am I supposed to have the answers? What am I supposed to do with my life? And where do we go from here? What's the point of any of this?
Socks are something we put on without thinking. But consider this. The very first socks were strips of cloth or hide wrapped around the feet. Imagine walking around in those. Thankfully, that's ancient history. And today's socks are much better for the soul. With so many styles and fibers, to truly understand what a science sock making has become. Here's a machine with the top open so we can get a view of the knitting action. An automated whirling cylinder pulls yarn from spools through holes in metal spokes. Little hooks on the needles grab the yarn. The hooks have latches. The latches open as the hooks snare the yarn and close as they knit so you don't lose a stitch. As you can see, this machine knits socks a lot faster than grandma, sometimes making over 360 pairs a day.